ahankar, how it exists in sushupti, the deep sleep. Chitta is like the a store of mind, which as such is never directly used. It's always used indirectly. Whatever we have perceived through our five senses, whatever our mind has experienced via perception, emotions, concept, sensations, feelings, that all gets automatically stored in the subconscious. Mind is sure the window, the senses are the window, mind is the next window, the second one, and then it goes all unfiltered in the subconscious. Filtering, or should I say the labeling, is done by your intellect. This is good, this is not good, nice, not nice, ugly, beautiful, logical, illogical, right, wrong, religious, irreligious, legal, illegal. All this labeling is done by the intellect. But remember, if mind is clouded or if mind is conditioned to see things in one way, then the labeling will also happen in that one way only. So that labeling is done to all the sensation, perceptions, concepts, feelings, ideas, and it's all being dumped into the subconscious. Whenever the mind in its interaction with others requires this information related to any, again, sensation, perception, cognition, emotions, feelings, then it very quickly everything gets checked or passed on from the subconscious to the conscious. If I say that if with some way we could delete the subconscious, actually your personality will be deleted. What is your personality? Only this? The idea which you have about yourself, given by others, went in through mind, stored in the subconscious. So in a way, subconscious is everything. In dream state, this subconscious actually begins to give a twist to whatever data has gone into it. That's why whatever dreams you have are actually not absolutely unrelated with whatever you experienced in form of reality. But in deep sleep, the mind goes into the darker zones, so does the intellect. But chitta is very much present there. That's why when you come out of the deep sleep, it's not that you need to learn everything from scratch again. If you had learned Spanish or English or Punjabi or Hindi or Sanskrit, when you come out of sleep, your all informations are intact and ready to be used. Your faith, your religion, your citizenship, your legal, social, family status, your education, your experiences, everything is as it is present when you come out of deep sleep. So the subconscious is very much dormantly passive even in waking state. Dormantly passive in the waking state. In dream state, it is not any more passive, it's more active actually. But it's still dormant. But in deep sleep, it is dormant, totally inactive, but is not deleted, is very much there. Actually, we can say like a tortoise goes back into its shell and can be in this hibernation for a long time. All the frogs go into hibernation, bears go into hibernation, they don't die. But their breath is totally suspended. And they stay in that stage for so long. But once the weather changes, they come out of the hibernation. So we can say that subconscious is like in a hibernation mode. It's very much there. Can't get deleted. As such, in dream state or in the waking state, subconscious is never directly active. It is your conscious mind which is active. But surely, minus the subconscious, mind cannot do anything at all. If, say, for some reason, your connection in between the subconscious and the conscious mind gets fudged, that's what happens in the Alzheimer's patient, that's what happens in dementia patients. They lose the ability to recognize themselves and others. So wife, husband, children, money, house. And they have that zombie face. It's not that their subconscious has somehow deleted. No, it's there. But the connectivity in between the subconscious and the conscious is not happening, because in between the brain, which is the hardware to run the software of mind, that hardware is now broken. Why Alzheimer happens, human science is still to discover that. They can just find out there are certain markers which tell whether this person will have Alzheimer or not. But the brain, because is diseased, hence the software of the mind cannot function. Brain is very much there. Even the ability to blink, Parkinson patients, these are reflex actions. They can't even follow that. So eyes are wide open. They can't, you know, blink. Or their eyes are closed. And then the eyes have to be kept open by taping the eyelids. But if they keep the eyelids like this for long, that gives them further more diseases. So Parkinson, Alzheimer, dementia, all these diseases of the brain can be a very, very big reason for the subconscious and the conscious mind's connectivity to go bunker. So in deep sleep, the subconscious is very much there, but goes into the dark, dormant, silent zone. Now, how is ahankar, the ego, there? What is ego? Over here it means I know it. If it is dream, you know it. If it is just asleep, you know it. Now, when I say I know it, for example, you need to open your eyes to see. So we can say the eye of the ego is from where I am, you know, with all these 10 senses, whatever is being perceived or received, is actually, the receiver is the ego. It's very, very subtle difference, because now what you see, I, is actually the ego. And when I say this I is Sakshi, I am not talking about the ego. But here is a very big confusion. To see where is that demarcation? It's like the, some people use the lenses for, they have myopia, so they use lenses, they don't use glasses. But if they are using lenses, nobody will know ever, until they tell that they are using the lens. So you can say that the ego is the most closest of all to me, the self, the Atman. That can be called the ego. So it is so, in a way, one, but because Atma is asang, unattached, like the lens in your eye doesn't get totally attached, but is still attached. Someone who is wearing a lens, I remember in Canada one time, I was a guest of a very nice family, and you know, unfortunately, things really prarabdha works, so it can break you or make you. When they met me, they had very nice couple, seemed like nice couple, two children. They were all young, 12, 14, like that. And these children just took fancy on me, and they would follow me wherever I would go, and these little children kind of cajoled and begged me that next time when I come to Canada, I stay at their place. And they had a huge place with a nice, huge, you know, garden lot behind their house. And it seemed very practical because if, say, 50 or 100 people want to meet me, there's a space, and it's good for, so for everybody's benefit, also for those kids, I agreed. Next year I stayed with them for almost, I think so, 10 days. And the lady of the house was a very business savvy, very outgoing, very smart lady. So she managed the whole, you know, program single-handedly. And unfortunately, well, in my two-year gap, I couldn't go to Canada, and then when I went, I came to know that they had a very, very bad battle. Husband actually complained to police that she's a threat to me and my children. Police threw her in jail. And she was they have the restraining orders. She can't go back to her house, she can't meet her kids. Kids were put into some foster home. And she went through a very, very rough patch. And finally they divorced. She came out of jail. And, well, cutting the story short, that is that her daughter, a young teenage girl, so one day, while we were sitting, so I just, you know, had a nice look at her face, and I said, "You're so beautiful." And such a blue eyes. And she kept on giggling and giggling and giggling. And then she said, "These are not real." I said, "What?" And I always thought that they are real, you know, blue colored. And she was very fair, so it suited her very nicely. She said, "It's just a lens which I'm using." And next day after night, actually, that very night, she, after removing her lens, she came and she said, "See, look, I have very black pupil." I said, "Well, that's nice. That was my first encounter with somebody who is using fashion lenses. I always thought they are like more if you have weakness and then the lenses are used." And actually, next day she went out to market and gifted me that set of colored lenses, you know, blue and hazel and brown and dark blue. And I said, what will I do with that? She said, no, no, you just keep it. You know, children are like very stubborn sometimes. And no, no, you just keep it with you. Maybe one day you like to go and you go out with those colored lenses and people will be so happy, like you were happy when you saw my eyes. I said, thank you very much. So that lens can be part of your body, but yet it is not. So we can say the ego is kind of attached closely with the self, Atman, but yet it is not. So I am experiencing waking state, I am experiencing dream state, I am experiencing deep sleep. Who is this I? So we can say it is the ego. But is it really ego? No, it's not. Why? Because ego in itself, in its natural composition, it is inert. Like the lens cannot see. The lens cannot see. But when that lens is attached to the pupil, is placed onto the eye, then the seeing happens. Or should I say, if say from dead person, well, the whole eye is not removed for donation. It's just the lens part of the eye is only taken out. But say if the whole eye is taken out and we place it on the table, can that eye see? Like people have those artificial limbs, you know, amputated leg or arm or hand, and they have that artificial limb. And they are walking. But is that leg walking? Or is it still that person walking? But that person doesn't have the real leg. But that amputated leg has been given the artificial leg, hence the walking is happening. It's very detachable. Like lens is detachable, like amputated, that artificial limb is very detachable. So we can say this ego too is very detachable. It is with me, the self, but it is not me. It is me, but it is not me. So mind, intellect, subconscious, and ego. Man, buddhi, chitta, ahankar. Out of which the chitta and ahankar are present in the deep sleep also. Now if we say there is, well, no ego, then who will see? The medium to hear, for example, is the ear. If there are no ears, then you cannot hear. Similarly, I, the sakshi, the witness, is there with the mind, intellect, subconscious, ego. But then these internal senses, if you remember in one kala, even man, buddhi, chitta, ahankara has been called as the part of the 14 senses group. So these 14 senses are being used by the self. So ego and chitta, the subconscious, is also being used by me. So I am there in it and yet not in it. There in it but not in it. So I know this deep sleep is, I know now it is not, now I know it is a dream state, now I know it is waking state, now I know I am lying. Everybody knows you are speaking truth. You can be so compulsively correct in projecting your lie as a truth, but your mind knows it's a lie. Or it is a truth. So mind and intellect, along with subconscious and ego, meaning the full format of the antakaran, is working in the waking state. But in the dream state, the intellect goes into dormant form. Mind is the king. That's why dream is also called manorajya. Mano means mind, rajya means kingdom. Dream is kingdom of mind. But when we say mind, Obviously, the subconscious is there. The chitta is there. Without chitta, there is no mind. Chitta is right there. So we can say chitta and mind are very prevalently active in the dream state. But in the deep sleep, even this mind along with the intellect go into the dark, dormant state. And as even in waking or in the dream, the chitta is always passively dormant. Passively dormant, but helping the mind and intellect to function in these two states. But in this is the state where, in a way, you can say the chitta is the king. In a way. And the ahankar is the king. So I am enjoying the deep sleep. I want to sleep deep. Right? The enjoyer of the deep sleep. Although it is me. It is me who is enjoying it. Actually, I don't even enjoy because I am the witness. But who enjoyed this deep sleep? Ego. So the ego and the subconscious are present in the deep sleep. And in nirvikalpa samadhi, the thoughtless state of total contemplation, the stillness of the mind. It's not just the stillness. In the nirvikalp, the thoughtless state of samadhi, even chitta goes into that, we can say, cleansing zone. That's why the seeds of all the impressions which are there in the subconscious get burnt in the nirbij nirvikalp samadhi, the seedless, thoughtless state of samadhi. Right?